Now that your programs are getting more interesting, with functions and logic and all of that, you'll likely find yourself introducing more mistakes into your programs. And it'll bug you when those mistakes keep your program from doing what you want them to do. You might instantly know what's wrong, but sometimes you have to spend some time debugging. And I want to give you some tips for doing that in this talk through. I've started with this program that has a white rectangle in the middle and instructions to click inside of it. When I click inside, I expect a rectangle to show up where my mouse was. But right now, it doesn't work. And if you want, you can pause right now and verify that that's true, that it's just not working wherever I click. All right, so why isn't it working? Well, let's debug it together. The first thing that I'm going to check is whether the mouse clicked function is being called at all. It should be called every time I click the mouse, but let's just check and make sure. An easy way to confirm that is to stick a print line right inside the function at the top. Clicked. All right, so now when I clicked, I see the console pop up and it says clicked. All right, so we know that mouse clicked is being called like we expected. This print line function here is a handy way to debug your program. And when you're done debugging, you can always remove the statements by deleting or commenting out and close the console. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is check to see if this code is ever reached here inside the if statement. Because what I'm really trying to figure out is whether this is ever true. So I'm going to put another print line inside the if, woo. And you might say like, oh, well, you know, there's a rect here. We would have seen the rect, but sometimes there could be a problem with what we're showing. There's never going to be a problem with doing a print line. So print line is the way to make sure that some code is getting called. All right. So now I'm going to try clicking again. Okay. I'm not seeing anything pop up in the console. All right, so that means that the thing that's wrong is that this is never true. So I have to figure out what is wrong with the condition in the if. Why is it never true? So to debug if and conditions, I often start with just printing out the values that I'm checking to make sure that they're what I expect. All right, let's see, click around. Yeah, so all of these values look really reasonable to me. So now I'm going to print out the conditions inside the if. So I'll take this first half here, and then I'll take the second half. And this just helps me narrow it down since this is a complex condition. All right. So what I'm seeing is that the first condition is true and the second one is false, when I expect it to be true because I'm clicking in the corner of the rectangle. So now I'm just gonna read through the condition and see. So mouse y greater than 100. So mouse y greater than 100. 100 is the left side of the rectangle and the top side of the rectangle. So for y, that makes sense that it should be 100. And then we have mouse y is greater than 400. Okay, well that's wrong because when mouse y is inside the rectangle, it's never going to be greater than 400. That would be outside the canvas. So what we really should be checking is that mouse y is greater than the top of the rectangle and mouse y is less than the bottom of the rectangle. And the bottom of the rectangle would be 100 plus 150, 250. And now we can see true. And so I'm going to go and change my condition here. And yay, rectangles. Okay, so now I'm going to keep clicking and I see that I can't get rectangles in the right side of the rectangle. So there's still something wrong with this first condition here. So let's read through this. So mouse x is greater than 100. That's right, because 100 is the left side of the rectangle. And then mouse x less than 150. Okay, so this is the problem here. 150, that only gives 50 pixels where this condition is true, but it should actually be true for 150 pixels because that's how wide the rectangle is. So this should be 100 plus 150, 250. Now we'll see it's true. I'm going to go and change this inside the if. And let's see. Woohoo! Rectangles everywhere we click. All right. So it looks like I've fixed everything. And I'm just going to, you know, check and keep clicking around, seeing if I missed any edge cases. See that, you know, everything is working as expected. Great. Now, you may have figured out what was wrong with my code before I did all of this print lines. But you'll probably run into code that's trickier than this. And you can use the same techniques for it. You just figure out which of your code is actually being run, and then figure out why it's not being run, or why it's being run in a weird way, by inspecting the values and conditions. And you can use println to do that really easily.